Josh, thank you for joining us today. We are very excited to talk OpenShift Virtualization, which is a hot topic around here, was a hot topic at our various summit and Summit Connects. So let's dive in. Give me a high level overview of OpenShift Virtualization.
Well, OpenShift has been established across the financial services industry for quite some time. A majority of the large accounts that I work in are using OpenShift as a container platform, as well as a place to deliver applications in a more modern, progressive way. However, most applications in financial services are 80%+ are still running in virtual machines, and it takes time for application owners to iterate and turn those into a more modern approach that's more cloud native. So Red Hat delivered this way to run virtual machines next to containers, orchestrate them just like you are running a modern cloud platform, but you know, with the form factor of virtual machines, containers, as well as serverless, and you get to pick and choose how you're running that, as long as you're running it on the bare metal devices that you have.
You touched for a brief moment on OpenShift and Kubernetes and the integration aspects. Walk me through a layer deeper, what that really means and how does it integrate?
Well, any cloud platform that you have has the basics of needing to orchestrate a bunch of things or processes or elements like virtual machines, containers, and otherwise on top of your infrastructure, your compute, your storage, your networking that you lay down. And Red Hat is including a lot of these components and capabilities out of the box to be able to support the attachment of virtual machines or containers or your AI models to a set of storage claims, as well as the network that you want to be able to interact with everything around it, or back to your own home network as well.
Within OpenShift and OpenShift Virtualization, and you talked about all of the components kind of coming out of the box, or in the box, I should say. How would someone get started? What are the key components that they really need to understand to get going quickly?
Well, Red Hat provides something called Advanced Cluster Management, which allows you to pull in the inventory of all your bare metal machines, and you can select to install OpenShift Virtualization, the necessary storage and networking configuration using the Advanced Cluster Management or Red Hat's cloud portal. As you define that configuration through a wizard or through configuration files, you're able to repeat this installation very quickly and also make sure that you're defining your desired deployment state and always keep it in synchronization with this very declarative base model or the intent of how you want to define it. And OpenShift is basically making sure that that infrastructure always aligns with your intended or your desired configuration in a continuous loop.
As you're talking about configurations, one of the things that comes to mind and how you set it up, sitting on the FSI team, the financial services team here at Red Hat, is security and compliance and all the regulations that go with it. Walk me through how OpenShift Virtualization helps in those key areas.
Well, first, financial services firms typically had was considered a very flat network where anything could talk to anything. As well as the encryption of storage and everything neat around it. Again, when you're allowing developers to configure all the interconnection between things and they have to take manual processes, it's almost inevitable that something is quite missing and it takes a long time to get to production, as you want to shift left, as they say. Start to configure these things earlier in your development cycle, define it declaratively. OpenShift can carry out a lot of those complex things that you're trying to configure, such as certificates for the interconnection between virtual machines or containers or other services that you have. In Red Hat, importantly, I mentioned that we have everything out of the box, or it's basically included in the platform. But we have a vast ecosystem of partnerships that provide security surveillance and security policy management, ensuring that the way it is configured is surveilled and works right into your security or InfoSec and cyber operations models.
As you're going through that and making sure you've got all the security and compliance needs being met, The other thing that comes to my mind is scalability. And we hear that from customers all the time is how do I scale this? What do I do? I'm a global institution or I'm a national institution. It's not just obviously one branch, for example, or one location for other businesses. How do they optimize and use OpenShift virtualization to get the scalability that they need?
This is somewhere where Red Hat thrives. Red Hat works in a community-based model, and we've built this, Kubernetes is now 10 years old. So Red Hat's been leading the charge with many other people in this open source community to build the platform in a way that will be scalable, secure, and modularized so you can integrate with whatever options that you want under it or integrate it through it or otherwise. So Red Hat led something called hosted control planes, as well as advanced cluster management, which allows you to lay down multiple clusters and connect them together and make sure that the platform and the clusters are always made to be resilient in nature. This scans that Red Hat's also operating OpenShift and OpenShift virtualization on cloud services such as Rosa. And we're taking that operational model and that scalability we can provide, but also allowing you to operate with scale as well. So our largest customer has over 1 million cores of OpenShift overall, and we're taking a lot of those lessons learned and making sure that it's much easier for people to operate at a similar scale as well, and operate up to 1,000 clusters at a time.
So you just touched on how one customer is using OpenShift and going to be implementing OpenShift virtualization. Give me some other use cases for OpenShift virtualization.
I'd say that OpenShift virtualization is fit for almost pretty much any use case. Many people have applications that are deployed inside of virtual machines and they need to interact with more modern containerized or cloud services. Those are easy to run in the platform and you get a lot of the same benefits of the live migration or making sure that as that machine might die under it, that it's staying up 100% of the time. We also see things like databases they need to run inside the platform, particularly things like a distributed database or a Mongo database. And we're certainly working on more and more use cases and working with the ecosystem of vendors that can certify and run at scale for really any type of use case that you'd want to run the platform from your other strategic virtualization providers.
All right, we talked about some use cases. Now, give me the pitfalls and the challenges that people need to be aware of.
I'd certainly say when people are first trying and looking at OpenShift virtualization, they might run OpenShift on top of another IaaS platform, such as a cloud or on top of another virtualization environment they have. To run OpenShift virtualization, you really need to deploy it to the bare metal infrastructure, so you're getting the maximum performance of the virtual machines. You have to take in those considerations for how you're going to operate this at more scale. And you know, explore the options for what you might be using for external storage, or if you want to host the storage directly in the cluster, OpenShift has lots of different options. I just say start with one of our partners or work with Red Hat or both of us to make sure that we're getting off on the right start.
You talked a little bit about getting off on the right start, but what should folks be looking at from OpenShift virtualization as it evolves to kind of meet future needs as well? So today is great, but what about tomorrow?
I'd certainly say that Red Hat is focused on maturing the core. I'd start by saying that, you know, the core of OpenShift virtualization is this project or this engine called KVM. So that's our virtualization engine, basically runs a process that hosts the whole virtual machine inside of it. KVM is established across the cloud providers as a mature virtualization engine. And Red Hat is doing additional work with how we integrate that with OpenShift to make sure that you can overcommit or balloon things like memory, and you can already overcommit the cores that you attach to platforms as well. So continue to partner with us and look how we're maturing the core of it. And Red Hat is even more focused on the more advanced networking use cases so that you can make the network that you attach to from your virtual machines look much more like a public cloud that you might be running in, or another platform with a network that cross-cuts multiple clusters.
Thank you so much for joining us. That was my last question. I hope everyone enjoyed this session. We look forward to many more with Josh and others. So if you have any questions, please feel free to reach out to us. Josh is happy to answer any questions, as am I. We look forward to working with you in the future. Thanks.
Thanks for having me.